This video will go over marginal analysis and how we use Excel as a tool to help us. There was another video that was really kind of the overall marginal analysis video. Hopefully you have taken the opportunity to look at that, but now we'll specifically look at how we might use it in Excel. So the problem that I've given here, it says the demand price of a particular smartphone at a specialty store is given by the formula, and there I've given you D of Q, where Q is the number of smartphones sold and D of Q is the price of each smartphone. So if you look at what I've done over to the left, you can see that I've set up three headings already, one for quantity, one for demand, and one for revenue. And obviously that really is just something that is review at this point. For quantity, I've taken a look through the problem and I see some numbers, so I went ahead and put in some values that I thought would be reasonable domain and answer the questions that I need as I look at the problem. For demand price, I simply typed in D of Q, negative 0.051 times my quantity, A3, plus 828. And then, of course, I drag that down. For revenue, my revenue simply comes from multiplying my quantity times my price. So for revenue, I just simply said A3 times B3, typed in that formula, and again, drag that down. Now, let's go ahead and answer a couple of questions that we have here. First, state the revenue function. Well, if this question were on our test, you would actually want to write the revenue function on the test. And for writing the revenue function on the test, you could simply say that R of Q is equal to Q times, put this in parentheses, D of Q. That would be perfectly acceptable. If you wanted to multiply it out and look at the quadratic function, that's fine. But you could just say Q times negative 0.051Q plus 828. What is the revenue when 2,000 phones are sold? So when 2,000 phones are sold, you can see that the revenue appears to be $1,452,000. What is the revenue when 6,000 phones are sold? When 6,000 phones are sold, it looks like the revenue is $3,132,000. The next couple of questions talk about marginal revenue. So for marginal revenue, you know that what we're thinking about here is the derivative. So we need to take the derivative of the revenue function. And the way that we're going to do this is we're going to use the cells that we have. And I want to show you what I did here. If I'm thinking about the formula Q times negative 0.051Q plus 828, and I really want Excel to be a benefit here, think about how I'm going to do this. I'm going to say the first, which would be my quantity, times the derivative of the second. Well, the derivative of D of Q is simply negative 0.051 plus the second, my demand price, which is that value, negative 0.051Q plus 828, times the derivative of the first, and the derivative of Q is simply 1. Now, I know that some of you may not do it that way. You may certainly find the derivative on your paper, with pencil and paper, and then type in the derivative. But I thought it would be worthwhile to just show you a way that Excel can benefit you in this nature. Enter that, and then again, drag it down. So the next thing that we want to be looking at is, well, what do these derivatives mean in terms of marginal analysis? So remember what marginal analysis is. It really is the, you know, when we're talking about cost, which was in the other video, it's the cost to produce the next item. So if we're talking about revenue and marginal revenue, it's going to be the revenue that's achieved on the sale of the next item. So when we look at these, in D it says, what is the marginal revenue when 1,000 phones are sold? So go back up to 1,000. The revenue is $777,000, but the marginal revenue, the revenue that would be achieved on the sale of the next phone or the 1,000 first phone, would be $726. What is the marginal revenue when 10,000 phones are sold? Well, at 10,000, we get a negative value. So I have summarized this, and I want to pull this out so that you can look at it and make sure that you understand what the words that I was using here. The marginal revenue when 1,000 smartphones sold is $726. This means that with the sale of the next smartphone, the revenue is $726. The marginal revenue when 10,000 smartphones sold is negative $192. This means that with the sale of the next smartphone, the store is actually losing revenue of $192. So then my last question is, what quantity provides max revenue for the store? Well, it should be obvious that the maximum revenue is going to occur, you know, we just evaluated 1,000 and 10,000, so we know it's going to be somewhere between 1,000 and 10,000, but we can narrow in even closer to what we have here, because at 6,000 we can see that the marginal revenue is $216. So let's go ahead and put in a dummy row to search from. I don't know, I think I'll put in 7,000. And when I put in 7,000, remember, if yours doesn't automatically fill, just to click your formulas all down, gives us the demand price, gives us the revenue, and then we can see here we still have a positive amount for revenue for the sale of the 7,000 first phone. What I want you to do is go ahead and goal seek from that cell. So we're going to go to data, what if, goal seek. And remember, we're looking for the maximum revenue. So every time we're looking for maximum revenue, we want to goal seek the revenue derivative, R prime of Q. We want to goal seek that to zero. And then what we want to do is change the quantity, the input. So what you can see there is that maximum revenue will occur when 8,100 and let's say 18 smartphones are sold at a demand price of $414. The company makes a revenue here of $3,360,705.88. The basics in this video really achieve all of the things that we need to do with marginal analysis when it comes to revenue. Remember, this would also extend to profit. So if we had a cost function here and we were able to set up cost and profit, then we could find the maximum profit where it would occur, again, by goal seeking our profit derivative to zero.